Welcome to Tucson, Arizona. We are here with the all-new 2024 Lexus GX 550. It's an SUV I am just so excited to drive that I lost my voice. Okay, not really. My voice is just a little scratchy. Sorry about that. Y'all just need to bear with me on that. But, oh, wow, this is a long time coming. Friends, family members, coworkers, friends of family, they've all been asking about the new GX, and here it is. What a looker. Can't believe that it's here in the flesh. Finally, we have a lot to cover when we're discussing this. Naturally, one of the first things you're gonna notice about the new GX is just how different it looks from the old SUV. It really does seem like Toyota start to listen to its really passionate fan base, as while there is a decent amount of Land Rover Defender in the new GX's shape, there's a whole heck of a lot of Land Cruiser DNA underneath the skin of the GX. And take this specific GX, for example. This is the all-new Overtrail trim that, at launch, is the most off-road-oriented and adventure-oriented version of the GX available.
Honestly, it looks like no other Lexus we've ever seen before. Its slightly angular, upright design and heavily revised design language is future-forward and absolutely on-trend. Beyond the extra capability, I do think the Overtrail is also the best-looking of the bunch. I mean, park it next to a standard GX and you'll quickly notice that most of the exterior trim is darkened. It's a welcome bit of contrast against this tan paint. Speaking of, this color is fittingly called Earth and it's exclusive to the Overtrail. Alongside the gorgeous Nori Green Pearl, I think it's the best color available. You know, it's not hard to imagine this toughest GX trim decked out with an array of Rotopax and Maxtrax boards. And that's far more than we can say of the last gen. The capability was always there, but even with a lift and some all-terrain rubber, the older GX has never quite shed that shiny suburbia skin.
Just like with the exterior, you're probably not going to recognize much on the interior of the new GX, and that's not a bad thing. They really went to town redesigning, revamping, updating, refreshing everything on the inside for the all-new generation. It looks great. There is a ton of toys and features and fan favorite stuff in here to look at, specifically because this is the Overtrail trim, which is at launch, like I said, the most aggressive off-road, active lifestyle, camping, overland type GX that you can get at launch. It comes with a whole lot of off-road controls, and that is what I want to talk about first, because it's arguably the coolest part of the car. So here, just like all GXs, we've got full-time four-wheel drive. So that is, you've got high four, low four. Again, there is no two-wheel drive option. It is full-time four-wheel drive. All GXs have a locking center differential, but the Overtrail is a locking rear differential. We asked them why no locking front differential, and Lexus engineers said that they didn't think they needed it. That's fine by me. So another cool thing is we have a lot of revamped drive modes for the new GX. And in addition to standard on-road stuff like Eco, Comfort, Sport, Sport Plus, we have multi-terrain select for the Overtrail, which includes stuff, you know, selectable terrain for rocky, muddy, snowy, that kind of stuff. The bottom DAC crawl button here, this is, so the DAC is for hill descent control, and the crawl function is, you know, like trail crawl. So think of it as kind of a very low speed cruise control on a trail. So it's up to 7 miles an hour. You don't have to worry about throttle input. You don't have to worry about throttle surging. It's all good. It's all handled by the crawl control. So here's another handy button here. It's just hit this for camera view. And I know there's really not much to look at and here on the grass, but imagine this was on a dirty, rocky trail, and you can keep an eye out 360 view for big rocks, debris in the road, keep those tires with that, you know, safe and undamaged. It's just kind of handy for you to have. Also for the off-road stuff, as you see this large screen, which we've already seen in the new Lexus TX, it's great. It's high resolution, it's high refresh, it's very reactive, it looks great. But as you can tell here, there's also a separate page for off-road functions, or rather off-road diagnostic kind of stuff. So we've got a tilt angle. If you didn't already know, you're in high four and in normal drive mode, or normal terrain mode, and then you have different readouts for throttle balance and brake balance that you are applying at the moment. Also handled here, of course, is standard infotainment functions. You've got nav, you've got Bluetooth, you've got all the good stuff there, and of course this is Apple CarPlay ready along with Android Auto. And you've got really handy here for the If you want to air up or air down, you can have the huge large display here. It even has integrated PSI for the spare. You've got, there's all sorts of good stuff in here. Lexus does elegant details really, really well. A lot of the trim is sculpted. If it looks like metal, it probably is. It's really nice finishing in here. The buttons are all soft touch. The plastics are all soft touch. The leather is really nice. There's some nice little suede in microfiber inserts. The stitching is really nice on this Overtrail. It's got a nice kind of green contrast. If you look at the door cards, there's a hexagonal kind of pattern. It's kind of hard to see. It might not come through in video, but there's some hexagonal design in there with some green accents. It's just a really nice, I would say, elegant, refined, and while rugged, place to be. I like it. For those interested in the Overtrail trim, something to keep in mind is that the Overtrail is only available in two-row configuration, whereas other GXs are standard with three rows. Now, those passengers that do sit in the back of your Overtrail will be quite comfy because in addition to their own climate controls, you also have heated seats for both sides and their individual USB-C charging port. Ah, another fun toy, almost forgot. Cool box in the center console, how neat is that? So I can't say that this air-conditioned compartment will keep your ice cream frozen, but it'll sure keep your soda cool. The previous generation of Lexus GX is best described in two words, truck-like. Now, that doesn't mean we didn't like the previous generation. I mean, part of the charm of the last GX is that it was a refreshing counterpart to the modern unibody crossover. Because the last GX, like the new one, I'm happy to say, was and is a body-on-frame SUV. And although the all-new 2024 Lexus GX 550 does share the same rugged body-on-frame construction as the old truck, I cannot stress how much of a holistic improvement in usability, comfort, and road manners that the new GX 550 is over the old SUV. Despite a boost in power and torque across the board, Lexus's new twin-turbo 3.4-liter V6 is proving to be the most controversial change about the new generation. People really like that naturally aspirated prior generation V8. People like the robustness, they like the reliability, they like the simplicity. Now it's true a twin-turbo V6 is never going to be able to match a naturally aspirated V8 for simplicity and robustness, but I gotta tell you, this thing feels like a stump puller. I mean, the torque is tremendous. We were doing a lot of low speed stuff today on the trails and it just pulls like a freight train. It feels great. Now, other than a sport and an optional sport plus driving mode, I tell you, the 2024 GX 550 has zero sporting pretensions, but with this torquey engine, I'll tell you, it gets onto the highway a lot quicker than you might think it would. Now you have a choice of suspensions when you're outfitting your new GX 550. You can have an adaptive suspension or a non-adaptive suspension. I was quite partial to the off-road Overtrail's version of that adaptive suspension, and I think blended with the off-road tires, it really made for a very soft, supple ride. Excellent body control, excellent bump absorption, really impressive across the board. At the moment, we are driving in a base model with the standard fixed non-adaptive suspension, and it is perfectly comfortable. There is no reason anybody would regret not getting the adaptive over the standard. It's just what your necessities require. Refinement is a common theme in the GX 550. I mean, the driver inputs are just so wonderfully balanced. The transmission mapping is smooth, it's intelligent. The throttle mapping is beautifully progressive. And the brakes, seriously impressed. The modulation of the pedal is nigh on perfect for this size SUV. As you can probably tell, we got rained out for the day. The GX is tough, but we are not. But we wanted to make sure to tell you that for the full review, breakdown, and information on the all-new 2024 Lexus GX 550, check out Cars.com.